Hi, welcome back to the Inner Sanctum with Freedom Gail. I want to talk to you today about the philosophy behind spiritual mind healing. This is a philosophy that I've learned from Ernest Holmes and other authors, but primarily Ernest Holmes. He's a spiritual psychologist, and that's my area also of interest. I've always loved religion, science, you know, history, spirituality, and believed that if I ever found myself in a situation in my life where I became sick, that I was going to trust God to heal me completely, that I was going to find the information that I needed, that I was going to be able to overcome my illness. And so earlier this year, I was in the hospital, and I've been trying to find out what was wrong with me and get well. You know, basically it came out that my adrenal gland had stopped working and it's leaking, and it stopped producing cortisol. So I had to learn how to walk all over again. I was in the hospital for 3.5 weeks, came out a couple of months later, ended up back in for 3 or 4 days, had to change my medicine. And all during this time, I found myself pretty scared. You know, I couldn't breathe. I was suffering cognitively and physically as well. And also they said I had a stroke. I think I was on the way to getting to that point where I ended up in the hospital. I have been having many strokes. And as I noticed in my videos, as I began watching them over, sometimes that the side of my mouth was down. And I know they say that's a sign and symptom of a stroke. And so when they told me, I wasn't completely surprised. Thank God I'm still here. And so I need to do everything that I can spiritually, intellectually, physically, and holistically to be well again. Okay, so the first place that we start is with the mind. You see, because when we believe, all things are possible. So the philosophy behind spiritual mind healing is that we live in an intelligent universe, a spiritual universe, that thoughts are things and that thoughts become things, that definitive states of mental consciousness, as they become subjective, they operate through an invisible or creative field that reproduces our thoughts in physical form. So basically what this is saying is that we live in an intelligent universe that is always working for us, and our thoughts become things, and that our thoughts are things, and that as we think our thoughts into this creative field or this creative medium, that it produces our thoughts into physical form. And so our thoughts are always creating for us, whether we're thinking negatively or whether we're thinking positively. This is such exciting news, and you want to know why? Because when you fully comprehend it, it's scientifically proven, and it works. When you really understand it, you'll see that it's scientifically proven, and you'll understand that it really works because you know how to use it. It's also saying that our thoughts are creative, you see. Therefore, learning to project our thoughts and think correctly will help us solve our problems of poverty, of illness, of suffering, and instead create the life that we desire. So we'll learn through thinking correctly, you know, how to create the life that we desire. And this life will also help us to live our dreams in all areas. We'll be happy. We can create wholeness for ourselves, financial stability, and also physical wellness, a physical well-being. You see, when we are born, or before even we are born, that we are in our mother's womb. We are subjected to everything mother says and everything that mother does. We can hear people around mother talking. We feel her emotions and are being preconditioned to behave, think, and feel in certain ways. You see, we are developing physically as well as intellectually also, and most likely even spiritually while we're in the womb, since we have conscious awareness and we are alive. You see, so you see, when we are born, what happens is that we take on the conditions that surround us, the external conditions as we grow up as individuals outside of our mother's womb continue to form us as we act with the people in the world around us. We're continually being formed. We're experiencing. We contemplate, react, and store all the information and all the experiences that we encounter. We make decisions about the circumstances of our life, and they become our beliefs and our norms, you see. Over time, we are subjected, all of us are subjected to or influenced and or hardened by negative experiences and unpleasant experiences, and it affects our mental, our physical, and our spiritual state, you see. As we become uncomfortable with our unhappiness, we have two choices. Either we can change or we can accept our unhappiness as our condition, okay, or as our reality. Many of us at times get stuck in the rut of negative thinking and downward thinking patterns and create a sense of hopelessness and despair for ourselves. So when we get stuck in that rut of negative thinking, we don't deliberately create downward thinking patterns and a sense of hopelessness and despair, but we find ourselves stuck there and we keep on talking about our problems. We keep on owning them. We keep on saying things, you know, that perpetuate the condition in our lives, you see. The spiritual mind healing involves becoming aware of our negative thinking and our behavior patterns and creating positive thought patterns that yield positive results. We don't focus on adverse conditions at all. We think only of what we desire to see as a part of our reality and in our lives. So we only think of what we desire to see or possess as our reality. Again, we turn entirely away from conditions. And this is one of the most important things. Don't focus on what the doctor says is wrong with you. Even when I got out of the hospital and my neurologist had me come and see him, and he would never say, you had a stroke. But he showed me a picture with these spots on my brain, and that was kind of freaking me out, you know. And I, you know, use comedy in a way, you know, to kind of process stuff. And my son was like, why are you laughing? Why are you joking? Because I was trying to, you know, absorb the things that he was telling me. And so he gave me a copy of these papers, and he's like, your immune system is way out of whack. You better go see a endocrinologist or rheumatologist right now before you have another heart attack and stroke. So I went home in fear. And I was afraid. I was afraid in the hospital. I was afraid when I got out of the hospital. And I was being left home alone a lot. I didn't have someone here with me all the time. And my son came for a few weeks, and then he had to go. Basically, he was getting on my nerves, so I sent him home. So anyways, I had to stop looking at the doctor's report. I had to come to a place in my mind and in my heart where I really believed God. And, you know, this was my time. This was my challenge. It has finally arrived for me. You know, I can no longer say things like, I am sick. I can't afford it. I don't feel well. You know, I have to turn entirely away from that doctor's report. And it was stuck in my head. Unconsciously, I kept seeing those test results and hearing his words, if you don't do this, then this is what's going to happen to you, you know? And I didn't want to go through that again. That was really scary. I really felt myself slipping away inside of, like, going backwards, and like I was only 50% present or alive, you know? So, in changing our thought patterns, we can no longer afford to think of the adverse conditions, you see. We can no longer afford to say, I am sick. I can't afford it. I'm too old. I give up. I'm never going to achieve my dreams. I can't do it. It's too hard. We replace those thoughts with the truth of our heart's desires, and we affirm our truths in absolute statements like, my body is the full manifestation of health and wellness. God is not sick. The universe is not sick. God is in me. Therefore, I cannot be sick. Furthermore, we affirm that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. Every day that I wake up, I affirm that I can do all things through the God in me. God is my helper. I cannot fail. God in me, with me, and through me cannot fail. I can achieve my dreams. My good is here now. All that I need is here now. I cannot fail. I claim my wholeness today. I claim my happiness today. I claim my complete healing, and that my body is the full manifestation of health and wellness. However, it's not just words that you can repeat. You know, you need to believe what you're saying. So the first way that you want to get started is to sit down and start listening to your thoughts. Write down what those negative thought patterns are that you have and the negative behaviors that you want to change. I almost ate a Big Daddy long leg. So you write down the negative thoughts that you have and the behaviors that you want to change, you know, and then you start writing positive affirmations for them. If you don't know any, look them up or get scriptures or, you know, whatever works for you. Just say the opposite of the negative thought. I am sick. I am not sick. God is not sick. The universe is not sick. Therefore, I cannot be sick because God is in me. I'll never find the love of my life. My perfect love is waiting for me in the here and now. I am on my way to finding that perfect love and to live happy forever. Anything that you're thinking that's negative, and give thanks for it being present now, because there, everything is here now that we need. Everything is here now for our life right now. So it's not just saying the words, it's believing them. It's saying them with faith, because even though we say the words, it's still our thoughts that are producing things. You see what I'm saying? Our thoughts. We can speak the word, and we speak the word, and we affirm the words until we come to a place where we believe them. And we keep talking and self-dialoguing until we get to a place that we can believe what we're saying. You see, we don't want to just spew out words that don't mean anything to us. So by this, we are countering, counter, our irrational thoughts. And this is something that I taught in counseling. You know, that is challenging them. You challenge, you attack them with truth. You tell yourself the reasons why they cannot be true for you. And then you establish reasons why they are. And you continue to do this every single time when you have a negative thought. You replace it with that affirmative statement. You write them down, carry them with you, repeat them over and over again until they become truth for you. And over time, they will become first nature. You see, they won't be second nature anymore. They won't be something that you do after you've already been find yourself sunken in negativity. You know, I know, I can remember a time when I used to pray down on my knees and get up and walk away, and I'd listen to my thoughts and I would hear myself thinking, oh, I'm never going to get that. God's not going to do that for me. Oh, he's too busy. Why would God even consider me? You see, but it's about us. God has established a system that when we believe that the universe, that the system, the field of the this invisible field that we plant our thoughts into, that is going to create for us what it is that we believe. You see, it's because of the subjective medium. You know, it's the law of God through nature. So, where am I? Okay. Over time, they become our first nature. The positive thoughts become our secret thoughts, replacing doubts, discouragement, and fear. And so, in conclusion, I just want to cover everything that I talked about here today. And the first thing is that we live in an intelligent and thinking universe. Our thoughts are things, and they're like seeds that we plant into the ground. And they yield whatever we planted. So if you plant a seed of apple seed, you're not going to get a lemon tree, you know. But isn't that kind of what we do, you know, when we go around and we, you know, pray and we ask God for something, you know, but then we take it back with our doubt and fear. You know, you don't feel worthy enough. You don't feel good enough for the thing that you're asking for. And your thoughts are being projected, you see, because God doesn't have to hear our words in order to know what we're thinking. The universe, the spiritual guides, they're ever present. They know who we are. They know what we're thinking. And even furthermore, by our behavior, you know, we're acting out what we really believe. So we speak into existence what it is that we want to believe. We challenge our irrational thoughts, and we establish a new premise. For every negative thought, you want to repeat that positive affirmation or that affirmative statement or treatment until it erases the negative thought, and then again to establish the new thought within your mind and out into the world, into the universe, as your spoken truth and your desire, and giving it a seed or plant that word, that thought, that belief into that creative medium or into that creative field. You see, because God created with the spoken word. When God spoke, everything came into being. And because we are created in the image and likeness of God, also when we speak, what we project, but even before that, God thought about what it is that he wanted, and then he spoke it out of his mouth. You see, that word is the tool, you know, our thoughts, you know, are just kind of like a place of deliberation where we decide and we follow our desire, you know, and then we speak what it is that we want, you know, but what we are speaking sometimes is not the truth of what's in our heart. So we want to make sure that if it's not the truth, that we examine that and that we counter our negative and irrational thoughts until they become true for us, okay? So our thoughts are creating for us all the time because our thoughts are creative. You see, they create things. And so whether we're thinking positive or negative, our thoughts are always creating. So you want to be very careful about what you're thinking. If you want to know what you're thinking, just look around at your life and you'll find out. If you like what you see, fine. You know, think about what you'd like to improve on and what you'd like to build for your future. If you don't like what you see, then change it. Stop repeating negative statements to yourself out loud to others over the phone. You know, stop telling that same old sad story. Stop repeating the I'm sick mantra, I'm poor, I don't have enough. Stop believing that, because God has everything. And like the song says, everything belongs to Him. You know, and all we have to do is ask, and it's right here for us. We have to receive it by faith, as if it, we already have it now, because like I said, everything is here now. You know, when we ask for it, all it comes to us, you know. So plan your positive thinking. You know, get up every day and spend 5 or 10 minutes deliberately thinking. This is what we call manifestations, or deliberately or consciously thinking about what it is that you want in your life. And take control of your thoughts. Even scripture says that we should take control of every thought and bring it under subjection to the Holy Spirit. And so when we have those negative thoughts and we're allowing them to wander around in our brain, we're allowing them to create and to change the very form and shape of our body. We're allowing those negative emotions to cause illness and suffering. You know, we end up living backwards, you know, out of sync with God and out of sync with love and law as God has created and intended for us to be our servants, you see. Dream big, you know. Create your life. Plan your positive thinking to create the life that you desire. Get the job. Get healthy. You know, start that business. You know, find the love of your life. Dream big. The universe is at your command. And remember, look only at what you want. Turn entirely away from adverse conditions. Stay with me as I talk more on spirit matters, and stay tuned for my new book entitled Love and Law, as it will explain some of the things that I'm talking about here in greater detail. It will explain the love of God through the natural laws of the universe, and we'll see how God has provided for us and how powerful and awesome and mighty and wonderful offspring of our Creator that we are. Not everything is right here for us now, that there is no need to worry about anything. You know, we've been definitely provided for and we've been cared for. And God's love through nature is very giving. It's not harsh and it's all inclusive. It works the same for everyone. So right now I'm going to get away from these bugs. This is my third take today. I lost the other two copies. So this one is going forward regardless of what. I never give up, and neither should you. Stay tuned. I love you. Peace and blessings.